गुड इवनिंग ऑल. इन टुडेज सेशन लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद फ्यू मोर प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन पीरियोडिक एंड नॉन पीरियोडिक सिग्नल्स. इफ यू रिमेंबर बिफोर दीपावली वी हैड टेकन द लास्ट क्लास, वी हैड सीन सम फाइव स्टेप्स, हाउ टू फॉलो सम फाइव स्टेप्स. इफ द गिवन सिग्नल एक्स ऑफ एन और एक्स ऑफ टी इज अ सम सिग्नल, सम मीन्स इट इज द समेशन ऑफ many signals. If your signal is sum of many signals, then we need to follow five steps to find the period capital T of this signal. So the most important condition to apply five steps is you should have this plus sign in between. If any signal is given to you, you should check for this. This plus sign should be there. If it's not there, try to convert it into that plus sign and then follow the steps. Just let me just show you. You can see it on the slide. On the I have shared the screen. The five steps to be followed. You can see. First, we need to obtain the ratio T1 by TI. I is the suffix used depending on the number of signals used. I is your this value of m. Okay. Anyhow, the numerator is T1. So first signal will be gone. Remaining all are the suffixes for I. I can be 2, 3, 4 up to M. So for example, if your signal X of T, if it has got four signals, sum of four signals, X1 plus X2 plus X3 plus X4. If this is the case, then this T1 by TI ratio will be I value will be either 2, 3 or 4. So accordingly, you will be getting how many ratios? You will be getting 3 ratios. T1 by T2, T1 by T3, numerator is constant. T1 by T4. So, agar 4 signals hain aapke paas, sum of 4 signals, if the given signal, then you should find 3 ratios. Okay. So first step is, quickly, let me glance, the ratio we need to find. Then we need to check whether this ratio is rational. If this ratio is rational, then it is periodic. If it is not rational, it is not periodic. Then third step, we need to go for finding the GCD. Actually, we need to find the GCD of denominator, but let us calculate for numerator as well. Okay, finding the GCD. Fourth step, we need to find the LCM of the denominator, that denote it as small l. And finally, the period of your signal X of T is the first signal's period T1 multiplied by the LCM. These five steps to be followed. So I have told you already how to know that whether we need to go for these five steps or the previous simple problems. The very first thing is your given signal should be the sum of periodic signals X1, X2, X3 means individually all signals are having their own periods and all are added. If this is the case and the addition is your final signal X of T. If this is the case, then it means that we need to go for application of five steps. Okay. So we have already solved few problems. I think the first problem we have already solved. Second problem, this, it was non-periodic because if you see the period root 2, if you go for the ratio calculation in the first step, root has come, which is irrational. That's why we cannot go further. In the second step itself, we will stop giving the reason that the ratio is irrational. Hence, your total signal X of T, which is the sum of three signals, it is non-periodic. Okay. The third problem was a homework. Few of you have sent me the answer through WhatsApp. I think two people have already sent me. They have solved it. Very nicely done. I'm very happy that you have tried. Let us just recall this homework assignment problem. This is your Z of N given instead of X. Z is given. And see, it is a discrete signal. Okay. Till now, we have solved continuous time signal. This is a discrete signal. It's a very simple problem, wherein only two signals are added. Till now, three signals we have seen. So here it is simple. Only two signals are there, Z1 and Z2. And individually, Z1 and Z2 are periodic. Okay. and if they are periodic with the periods 90 seconds and 54 seconds, we need to go for finding the fundamental period capital N for your sum signal Z of N. Yes, UM sum. Very first thing, list out the given data. I will denote the period of the first signal as N1. Please make it 90 seconds. This also in 54 seconds. Let us start following the steps. First, we need to go for finding the ratio T1 by TI. Here it is discrete, so it will be N1 by NI we need to find. I range is from 2 to M. Okay. If you just observe the suffix, you have 1 and 2. 1 is already covered in the numerator. The only left out is the suffix 2. So I will be having the value only 2. You don't have any further terms. So only 2 signals means only 1 ratio will be there. N1 by N2 ratio. It is simple problem. So if you just take N1 by N2, it is 90 by 54. Let us try to reduce it in the ratio or ratio form, which is a rational number. Let's see whether we get the rational number or not. 3 threes are 3, this 0 is as it is, 3 threes are, 3 ones are 3, 3 eights are 24, then 3 tens are 3 sixes are, then 2 fives are 2 threes are. So we'll get 5/3. Further, we cannot reduce it. So 5/3, we got a ratio which is the rational. The whole numbers are there, integer numbers we have got. Okay, no roots, nothing. No pi, no roots. So this is a rational ratio. So what is the decision? Yes, we concluded that the given signal Z of N, it is a periodic in nature. Hence, we need to follow the remaining steps. So the third step is we need to go for finding the GCD. GCD of numerator. What is numerator? We have a numerator 5, denominator 3. So for 5, GCD is either 5 or the GCD, greatest common divisor, is 1. And for 3, it is again 1. 1 is the common. If you don't get anything, 1. Okay. Then try to represent this ratio 5/3 in the form of GCDs. Means 5 into 1, 3 into 1. Okay. After this, let's go for fourth step, finding the LCM of the denominator. So what is the denominator? Denominator, you have, if you see, you have got the denominator 3 and 1. Okay. After you represent the ratio in the form of GCD, it is here. The denominator, if you observe, it is having the number 3 and number 1. So for this, you find the LCM. LCM of 3 and 1, it is obviously 3. So L is equal to 3. So what is the final step? Final period capital N. Don't mix up with the continuous time capital T. Okay, we are now in discrete time. So capital N is the first signal Z1 of N's time period N1, which is 90 seconds given, into the LCM 90 into 3, which is 270 seconds. Okay, I hope you understood this problem. We'll go for one more problem. It is the most frequently asked question in the question paper. Okay. If you see the given signal X of N, it is cos of some angle multiplied by sine of some angle. Cos A into sine B, something like that. Okay. Now, as I have told you, in order to apply the 5 steps, it is mandatory that your X of N signal or X of T signal should have a plus sign in between. Okay, I have told you this. This is the condition. But according to the given question, you have a multiplication. So before going further for applying the 5 steps, what you do, you try to apply some trigonometric formula, which you already know, cos A into sine B. You apply the formula and try to convert the given question in the form of plus. Okay, so I have already written here. You can see it on the screen. I have written cos A sine B formula 1 by 2 sine A plus B minus sine A minus B. This is the formula for cos A into sine B because the question is of that form, cos A into sine B. So apply the formula 1 by 2 as it is, sine of A is pi n by 5, B is pi n by 3. I have written that plus and minus. So simplify it further. Solved it here. You can see on the left side how this can be solved. The first bracket a plus b, how it can be solved. Take the LCM, it will become 15. Okay, 5 and 3, LCM is 15. Then cross multiply, this will become 3, this will become 5. Okay, 15, or 5 threes are 15, 3 fives are 15. If you add 3 plus 5, 8 pi n by 15 you will get. So 8 pi n by 15. Similarly, if you subtract both, denominator is 15, 5 threes are 3, fives are 15. So 3 minus 5, 3 minus 5 is minus 2 pi n by 15. You will get minus inside. Okay. But when you take sine of minus theta, this is the trigonometric function. You might have seen this identity. Sine of minus angle is minus sine theta. And similarly, if it is cos of minus theta, how will you write? It is cos is positive. Cos theta, negative will go, but for sine it will come outside. Sine is odd function, cos is even function. So I have added, and if this negative and this negative, multiplication will become positive. So if you observe here, the given question was having the multiplication, we have converted to addition. So now you can apply the 5 steps. Now how can I tell that the 5 steps can be applied? The condition, one more condition, apart from this plus sign, one more condition is both these individual signals should be periodic. So they are periodic. I'll just show you how. First bracket, if you see, it is 8 pi n by 15. So if you compare this signal with sine omega n, standard signal sine omega n, omega is 8 pi by 15 comparison. But what is the periodicity condition for a discrete signal to be periodic? It is, it should be multiple of 2 pi and it should be in the form of ratio m by n1. Okay. If this is the ratio, if this is the ratio, it should be a multiple of 2 pi and m or m by n form. So if you just try to represent this 8 pi in terms of this, how can I write 8 pi? Split this 8, okay, in the form of multiples of 2. 2 into 4 is 8, right? So I have written that 2 pi into 4, right? This is numerator. 8 pi can be written as 2 pi into 4. Our denominator is 15. How it is 15, this is the denominator, right? So now if you compare the LHS and RHS, you can see that it's clear. 2 pi, okay, m is equal to 4, n is equal to 15. So 15, we got n, the time period, the fundamental period. For the first signal, we got it 15. So it is periodic with the number 15. But in earlier problem, which was a homework problem, it was directly given to you, 90 and 54. But this time in the given problem, what we did, we have converted the multiplication into addition first, and individually the time periods we are calculating. That's the difference. It is a bit lengthier. Similarly, go for the second signal. After comparing the second signal with the standard signal sine omega n, what is omega? Omega is, I missed here n, small n. It is missing. Please add it. Sine of 2 pi small n. Here also it is missing. I need to add it. Right? Everywhere you need to add this. So if you compare, omega is 2 pi by 15. So again, the condition for a discrete signal to be periodic, it should be multiple of 2 pi. 2 pi into m by n. So you have already 2 pi in the numerator. Don't do anything. Just put 1, 2 pi into 1. It will be again 2 pi only. So compare LHS and RHS. These are 2 pi's. M is equal to 1. N is equal to 15. Denominator, N is equal to 15. So in both the cases, we have got the time periods N1 and N2 as 15, 15. in the earlier problems which we solved, this value of time period was directly given to you. This time we have calculated. Now we can apply the five steps. First step is taking the ratio of T1 by Ti, right? It is discrete signal, so I'll go for N1 by N2. We don't have any possibility of N1 by N3 because we have, if you see, we have only two signals, summation. अगर मेरे पास और एक सिग्नल होता सम सिग्नल सो रेशियो कैन बी N1 by N2 एंड वन मोर रेशियो N1 by N3 इफ आई वुड हैव गॉट वन मोर सिग्नल हियर बट वी हैव वेरी सिंपल सिग्नल समेशन ऑफ ओनली टू सिग्नल्स दैट्स व्हाई इफ यू जस्ट ऐड इफ यू जस्ट फॉलो द स्टेप्स वी विल बी गेटिंग ओनली द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ वन रेशियो N1 by N2. Okay, so both are 15-15. So they get cancelled 1 by 1. The ratio is rational, right? So the ratio is rational. So second step is yes, the ratio is rational. Hence, the given signal is periodic. Go for the third step. Third step, find the GCD of numerator and denominator. Numerator 1, denominator 1. What will be the GCDs? 1 and 1 only. So try to represent the ratio in the form of GCDs. 1 into 1, 1 into 1. Most simplest problem. Then fourth step, find the LCM of the denominator, small l. So what is denominator? Check here. It is 1 and 1. So what is the LCM of 1 and 1? Again 1. So l is equal to 1. So finally, the fifth step, the time period capital N is equal to your first time period of the first signal multiplied by the LCM. So for the first signal, if you see, we have already calculated, both are 15-15 only. So time period of the first signal, it is 15 into the LCM. LCM is 1. So answer is 15 seconds. I hope you understood this problem. It's a very simple problem. Just you need to, you know, understand it concept. When to apply the five steps. वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग इंडिविजुअल जो सिग्नल्स होते हैं एडिशन में वो सभी सिग्नल्स पीरियोडिक होने चाहिए उनके पीरियड्स आपको पता होने चाहिए एंड द इन बिटवीन साइन जो रहते हैं वो सम होना चाहिए देन ओनली यू शुड अप्लाई द फाइव स्टेप्स सिमिलरली वन मोर प्रॉब्लम यू कैन सी एक्स ऑफ एन इज गिवन एज कॉस एंड कॉस कॉस ए कॉस बी बट हियर sum is there already plus is there no need to convert no need to apply any formula okay directly aapko sum form mein diye hain it means cos of first angle give you the first signal and cos of this 2 pi n by 7 it is your second signal cos and cos both are cos terms so what I'll do as I want the individual time periods let me calculate the individual time periods for the first signal if you I compare the given cos signal with the standard signal cos of omega n what is omega omega will be 2 pi by 5 okay then according to the condition for a signal to be periodic it should be multiples of 2 pi omega should be multiple of 2 pi multiplied by m by n ratio so try to represent this omega 2 pi by 5 in this form न्यूमरेटर में ऑलरेडी 2 पाई अवेलेबल है सो व्हाट यू नीड टू डू सिंपली मल्टीप्लाई द न्यूमरेटर बाय 1 एंड 5 डिनोमिनेटर क्लब दिस 1 बाय 5 नो नीड टू एडजस्ट बिकॉज ऑलरेडी 2 पाई इज अवेलेबल टू यू नाउ कंपेयर द LHS एंड RHS 2 पाईज आर देयर m इज इक्वल टू 1 n1 इज इक्वल टू 5 सेकंड्स दिस इज द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ द फर्स्ट सिग्नल सिमिलरली गो फॉर द सेकंड सिग्नल try to compare the second signal cos with your standard signal cos omega n it is 2 pi by 7 if you compare the omega again for periodicity condition try to represent omega in the form of multiples of 2 pi again no need to do anything already 2 pi is available with you so simply multiply by 1 and denominator keep it as it is so 2 pi's are already there m is equal to 1, n2 is equal to 7. Okay. So I have got after comparison n2 as 7. N1 as 5, N2 as 7, 5 and 7. These are the two time periods. Now let me go for five steps. First step, N1, I forgot this, N1, okay? It is N1 by N2. The ratio is 5 by 7. No need to go for any division because I can't divide no common factor. So ratio, keep it as it is. It is a rational ratio. Okay, whole numbers are there. No root, no pi. So rational numbers are there. Hence, the given signal is periodic. So third step, go for finding the GCD. GCD of numerator and denominator. What is numerator? It is 5. Denominator is 7. So what is the GCD? See, you can find the GCDs of two values. See, if I have, say, 2 and 3, I can find the GCD as 1. If I have, see, the number 2 and 4, the GCD will be what? 2. Because I can divide this 2 and 4 by either 1 or 2. 2 ones are 2 twos are. So out of this, the greatest common divisor is 2, right? So in order to find the GCDs, I need two numbers, but only one is available. That's why directly put as 1, 1. Once you do this, try to represent the given ratio in the GCD form. 5 into 1 divided by 7 into 1. Okay. Once you get this, observe the denominator. Denominator has got 7 and 1. Okay. 7 and 1, out of which you can find the LCM of the denominator. It is equal to 7. And finally, the time period is given by the first time period, N1. What is N1? 5 seconds. N1 into the LCM. 5 into 7, which is 35 seconds. 5 sevens are 35. One more problem. I think this is a simple problem which I have taken. X of N is equal to cos square. I think it's a repeated problem. Cos square. Yes, Huma, you're telling something.
I didn't understand.
Which you did not understand?
That second one, cos.
This one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Nothing. You just have to compare it with your cos omega n. What is omega? Omega is 2 pi by 7. If you compare, omega is equal to 2 pi by 7. The condition for any discrete signal to be periodic is your omega should be the multiple of 2 pi and multiplied by m by n form. जो भी आपका ये जो वैल्यू आता है आफ्टर कंपैरिजन उसको इस फॉर्म में रिड्यूस करने की कोशिश करो. मल्टीपल्स ऑफ 2 पाई आना चाहिए, एक रेशियो होना चाहिए. इफ यू जस्ट सी, ऑलरेडी 2 पाई अवेलेबल है, हमको 2 पाई चाहिए इक्वेशन में. ऑलरेडी यहाँ पे न्यूमरेटर में 2 पाई है, सो इसीलिए मैंने यहाँ पे 1 रखा है. 2 पाई इंटू 1, 2 पाई ओनली. एंड डिनोमिनेटर में जो है इसको इसके साथ जोड़ दो, सो दैट ये रेशियो को आप इससे कंपेयर कर सकते हो. दैट्स इट. Then m is equal to 1, n is equal to 7 after comparison with LHS and RHS. So then after that, following the 5 steps. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next problem, if you see, it is a cos square theta. I have applied the formula of cos square. I think this is a repeated problem. Cos square theta, which is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So that I have done 1 by 2, 1 plus cos of 2 into theta. Theta is pi n by 8, 2 ones are 2 fours are. So it will be like this. Out of which, for the second one, let me apply the periodicity for the second term, because first term is a constant amplitude. So if I compare this, if I go for this, compare this with cos omega n term, omega value will become pi by 4. So omega is pi by 4. But according to the condition, I should represent this pi by 4 in this form, m by n. Is form mein humko represent karna hai pi by 4 ko. Okay, pi by 4. 2 pi chahiye, sirf pi available hai. What I will do, I will multiply by 2 and divide by 2. So that numerator mein 2 pi aa jayega. And denominator you check. Denominator will be, ye 2 pi ko as it is rakho, 2 into 4, it will be 8 and nothing means 1. So what I have done, 2 pi ko bahar rakke, 1 by 8, jo ratio hai aapka, that 1 by 8, I have taken it separately. So once I do this, I can compare, 2 pi's are there, m is equal to numerator 1, n is equal to denominator 8. This is how we solve it. It's a repeated problem. If you see here, I will solve 7th, 8th will be a homework. 7th problem, if you see, x of t is equal to 2 cos 100 pi t plus 5 sin 50 t. It's a continuous signal. Okay? 5 steps apply karne ke liye humko ye zaruri hai ki plus sign hona chahiye. Sum of x of signal, x of t, it's a summation of two signals. Okay? So first signal is cos, second signal is sign. So let me start. Unke periods pata nahi hai. They have not given you in the question. So first let me find the periods. For that, if you just compare omega, omega is equal to what? 2 pi by t. So omega is 100 pi, 2 pi by t. 2 pi by t1 for omega 1, first signal. 2 pi by t1 is equal to 100 pi. So if I cancel, 2 and pi pi cancels. 2 1s are, 2 50s are. So t1 is equal to 1 by 50 seconds. Similarly, if I go for the second signal, which is 50, see here the angle sine omega t. Standard signal is sine omega t. Second signal hai, to omega 2 le lenge. Ye first signal tha, isiliye isko cos omega 1 liye hai. So if you compare sine omega, omega 2 is equal to 50. Omega is 2 pi by t2, which is equal to 50. 2 ones are 225s are and 25 by pi, pi by 25. T2 is equal to, ye T2 ko idhar le jao, 25 ko niche leke ao. So T2 is equal to pi by 25 seconds. So individually T1 and T2 humne find out kar liya hai. Let us now go for application of the steps. If you see, first step is we need to find the ratio T1 by Ti. I is equal to 2. Further we can't do anything because the equation mein sirf do signals hain. Okay? So ek hi ratio aayega, T1 by T2. So T1 is 1 by 50, T2 is pi by 25. So 25 ones are, 25 twos are, 50. Ratio will be 1 by 2 pi, right? Yahan par aapko numerator mein 1 by 2 bach gaya, denominator mein pi hai. So ye 2 aur ye pi multiply ho jayenge, 1 by 2 pi. So pi term aaya hai ratio mein, it's an irrational number. Hence the ratio is irrational. So stop at the second step itself, telling the reason that the signal is non-periodic because the ratio is irrational. Okay? Agar yahan pe pi nahi hota, agar aapka ratio sirf 1 by 2 hota, to aap isko periodic bolke third, fourth, fifth steps continue karte, GCD, LCM, finding the period. But as the given, you know, the ratio jo humne calculate kiya hai, usme pi term hai. The value, if you see, it is an irrational ratio. That's why we will stop at this only. Okay. Take this eighth problem as a homework and try to solve by yourself. Given signal, if you see the difference between these two signals, see cos 100 pi t, cos 100 pi t. No doubt amplitude change hai, 2 and 1. It doesn't make a difference. Yahan par sin 50 t hai. Yahan par sin 50 pi t hai. Difference aapko pata chala dono problems mein. Humne yahan pe stop kiya tha because pi term existing tha. But jab aapka question thoda change kar liya gaya hai. See here 50 t and 50 pi t. The question has been you know, mauled a little bit, moulded. If you see pi term is there, jab aap continue karoge to ratio mein aapko pi cancel ho jayega. Jab ratio mein pi cancel ho jayega to ratio rational ho jayega. Jab rational ratio aayega to aapko third, fourth and fifth steps ko continue karna padega. That is your eighth problem. So take the eighth problem as a assignment and try to do by yourself. The given signal is x of t, which is cos 100 pi t. Let me just zoom a little bit so that it is visible clearly to you. Let me underline it. This is your signal. cos 100 pi t plus sine 50 pi t. This is the signal. This is your first signal. This is your second signal. So already some signal is there. Plus sign is already with you. First, आपको क्या करना है? ये period find करो. Second, ये period find करो. After comparison, cos omega t and sin omega t से. After that, follow the 5 steps. First step में आपको ratio rational मिलेगा. And try to find the final time period of 5th step. Okay, this is the homework. I think one more problem is there. Let me put that also. This is the question. X of t is equal to 2 cos t plus 3 cos t by 3. That is 1 by 3 t. 1 by 3 t. So this is one more problem. You try to solve it. One is that earlier problem. Two problems homework de rahi hun. This is first 8th problem. Try to do it by yourself. And one more problem, 9th problem, x of t equals to 2 cos t plus 3 cos 1 by 3 into t. Please try to find the time period of your final signal x of t. Okay. With this, we completed periodic and non-periodic signals. So in the next session, we will go for the last classification in the signal classification part. That is energy and power signals. The important again, we have seen already even odd, then periodic, non-periodic. Based on them, we will use certain concepts of both and we will try to find the energy and the power signals. How to find the energy, how to find the power, you know, we will see certain problems also based on that. Okay. Any questions, any doubts in this class, please you can ask me.